antara aspek-aspek berikut. Kita tahu yang kita ada empat data dalam bentuk numerik, betul? So kita ada IV. IV kita terdiri daripada age, lagi salary dan juga CGPA. Kemudian kita ada DV. DV kita ada satu, namanya knowledge score. Okey. Daripada data-data ini, semua data ni tak bertaburan normal secara khusus. Yang bertaburan normal cuma kita punya yang normal hanyalah CGPA dan juga knowledge. Oleh itu, yang kita akan proceed dengan Pearson correlation hanyalah these two variable. Okey, dua variable ini sahaja yang akan melibatkan diri dalam ujian Pearson correlation ataupun dalam bahasa panjang dia Pearson product moment correlation. So Pearson product moment correlation ni cara nak buat dia mesti ada hipotesis lah. So hipotesis seperti mana yang telah dinyatakan di sini, tidak ada significant correlation antara IV dan DV. IV kita CGPA, DV kita adalah no knowledge. Same also goes to the alternative. Kita akan buat alternative ada perkaitan yang significant antara IV dan DV. IV kita apa dia? CGPA. DV kita adalah no knowledge. Kemudian alpha kita adalah 0.05. Ini mengikut jumhur ulama. Kemudian kita akan run or calculate. So to run and calculate this method is very simple. You can just click the analyze and then proceed with the correlate and bivariate. Ini saja. Analyze, correlate, bivariate. Bivariate di sini merujuk kepada dua variable. Bi maksudnya dua kan? Bisexual maksudnya apa? Dia buat seksual secara lelaki dengan perempuan. Bi. Homo, satu. Dia ada tak hetero? Ada. Hetero macam mana hetero? Hetero orang normal lah kan? Betul? Betul tak? Tak tahu eh? Oh, tak pernah dengar benda-benda ni, istilah ni. Oh, memang suci hati eh? Bagus eh? Okay, never mind. Analyze. Nampak semua muka macam terkejut. Macam first time dengar eh? Oh, memang you all ni semua adalah insan-insan yang soleh. InsyaAllah eh? Analyze, correlate dengan bivariate. Kemudian anda masukkan maklumat berikut. So, kita telah tahu DV kita adalah knowledge. Betul? Knowledge kita ni dalam numerik ke tidak? Ya. Adakah ada bertaburan normal? Ya. Lalu kita masukkan di dalam variable box. Awak tak boleh tekan OK pun. Sebab apa? Bivariate analysis memerlukan sekurang-kurangnya berapa variable? Dua variable. Oleh itu, variable yang lagi satu adalah daripada kalangan IV. IV kita ni adalah yang diberitahu oleh literature adalah make sense to be analyzed. Eh? Jangan letak sebarang-sebarang lah. Macam saya bagi tahu contoh yang sebelum ni, faham? Kadar perpeluhan berkait dengan gaji. Lagi banyak peluh, keluar, lagi banyak gaji dapat. Dia tak ada kena-mengena. Dia mestilah betul secara teori dan pernah dibincangkan di dalam scientific body. Faham kan? Macam ni lah. Contoh macam CGPA. Memang ada kaitan dengan knowledge. Lagi tinggi CGPA, kita berandaian orang tu akan mempunyai tinggi IQ dia. So, bila tinggi IQ, maka dia adalah bijak. So, dia pun akan bijak jugalah dalam bab DLP ni. So, itu yang kita nak tengok. Salary, seperti mana yang saya kata tadi. Lagi banyak duit dia dapat, lagi selalu dia pergi kelas tuition dan lain-lain. Contoh. Age, lagi banyak pengalaman dia, lagi banyaklah knowledge dia. Kononnya. Okay, contoh. So, dalam this episode, kita akan letakkan CGPA sebagai faktor yang kita nak lihat perkaitannya. We want to see there is any relationship between these two variable. DV, knowledge, and also IV is age. Now, you can just click OK or paste it accordingly lah. When you paste it, it will appear in your, this one. In your what? In the syntax. So, daripada syntax ni, you boleh highlight. You highlight dan tekan Ctrl R ataupun run. Dia akan keluar this table. Can you see this table or not? In your computer. Can you see the table? Oh, you cannot see the table. Oh, you cannot see anything that I show to you now. You can see, right? Okay. So, now apa yang ada pada Pearson correlation ini, dia ada dua benda sebenarnya yang dia cerita kat sini. Satu benda ini dinamakan sebagai R. Yang ini dinamakan sebagai R. Pearson correlation yang you dapat ini adalah R. R menceritakan mengenai apa? Dua benda. Strength and also direction. So, direction dia ada positif ataupun dia letak indikator negatif. Dalam kes ni ada negatif tak? Tak ada. Jadi, dia adalah positif. Kemudian, dia juga menceritakan mengenai strength. Strength berdasarkan Gifford Rule of Thumb. Gifford Rule of Thumb bagi tahu kalau kurang daripada 0.2 dikira low, 0.2 until 0.4 dikira sebagai, sorry, less than 0.2 dikira sebagai negligible. Kemudian 0.2 until 0.4 low, 0.4 until 0.7 is moderate. Kemudian 0.4 until 0.7 is considered high, more than 0.9 is considered very high. So dalam kes ni kita dapat nilai R kita adalah 0.092, kurang daripada 0.2 Clifford rule of thumb. So apa maknanya? Ma maknaha fi hazhil 0.09? Pandai, negligible. That means there are no relationship at all between CGPA and knowledge, even though it's a positive direction. And it's also been conquered and it's also been proved by looking into your SIG value. SIG bawah tu adalah nilai P. Bawah tu SIG to tail. Nampak tak? Itu menunjukkan anda punya nilai P. P anda yang asal pada step nombor 2 adalah 0.05. Correct, Anand? And then you are going to compare your P value that you gathered from this analysis. 0.647 is more than or less than your alpha that you being set already at 0.05. More than or less than? More than. Therefore, you need to decide whether you want to reject or fail to reject. In this case, you want to reject or fail to reject null hypothesis. Pandai. You fail to reject the null hypothesis and therefore you are going to make a conclusion. What kind of conclusion that you can derive based on that decision? There is no. There is no relationship. There is no significant relationship between independent variables and also the dependent variables. In this context, we are saying that the CGPA, it's not something related or it's not related at all statistically with the knowledge about the DLP. Faham kan? Itu dia punya cerita. Samalah juga kalau anda ingin menceritakan, if you want to talk about the other variable also is the same. For example, if let's say your variable is not normally distributed, therefore you cannot proceed with the Pearson product moment correlation, you may want to use the alternative non-parametric test. We call it as the Pearson correlation. Spearman-Rowe correlation. Spearman-Rowe correlation have two functions. To see the correlation between two numeric variable, IV and DV, that is not normally distributed, and also you want to know the relationship with the ordinal scale. So sekarang ordinal scale kita ada tak? Ada contoh macam knowledge ni kan? Knowledge DLP. Knowledge soalan nombor satu ni awak nak tengok dengan perkaitan apa-apa saja yang dalam bentuk numerik yang logik boleh juga digunakan. Tetapi that is not my focus this evening. I'm just going to look into my important IVs, namely as age and salary. Because these two variable are not tabulated normally, and therefore only one tabulated normally known as knowledge score. Itu sebab saya pakai Spearman-Rowe correlation. Beza dia dekat mana? Dekat sini. You unclick the Pearson, you click the Spearman. Okay, can you do that? And then you can hit the paste button or okay button. In this case, I'm already save it inside my dalam syntax dah ada. Okay, ini adalah anda punya output. Nampak eh? Please focus on this output lah. Sorry, saya tak nak bagi you confused. Saya buat semula. Analyze, correlate, bivariate. Kemudian you masukkan data-data yang berkenaan. Data ni normal, data ni tak normal. Ni dua atas ni, tidak normal. You click kepada Spearman. By default, dia kira Pearson. You jangan klik Pearson. You klik Spearman sahaja. And then you can hit the OK button or paste button inside your syntax command. After that, you are going to make an interpretation. Based on this, you no need to look everything. You just focus on one particular row or one particular column. My experience, I'm only looking into the one column. I usually look only on the DV. For example, in this case, I only focus on this particular column. Why? Because I want to see, is there any relationship between knowledge and salary? This one. Knowledge and age. Macam tu. Knowledge dengan knowledge tak payah tengok pun tak apa. Sebab dia adalah benda yang sama. So in this case, can you see knowledge and age? Knowledge and age, ini dia punya correlation coefficient. Spearman-Rowe correlation ditulis dalam bentuk RS. R huruf besar, S adalah subscript. Yang kecil tu, bawah tu. Boleh bayang? Boleh bayang ke tak boleh bayang? Boleh, pandai pun. Macam gini. Contoh dia R, S. S ni kecilkan ke bawah. ni, macam ni, RS. Kalau kamu nak buat dalam penulisan thesis, this is how you want to write it, the thesis format of the reporting correlation data. Nanti saya tunjukkan macam mana you nak buat tabulation of data for your output. No problem. After this, I will share with you how. Okay, based on this particular data, kita tengok knowledge, dia bagi correlation coefficient RS dan dia bagi juga correlation coefficient for all of the variable. Now, kita nak tengok satu-satu. Boleh eh? So, the first one, we look into this. This is the RS for the knowledge and age. Berapa nilai dia? 0.263, right? More than 0.2? Yes. But it's within 0.2 until 0.4. Betul? So, what is the no? The direction and strength. Direction is positive. The strength is low. So, low positive correlation. However, we need to back it up. Kita kena tengok balik kita punya p-value. This is our p-value. Our probability value indicate 0.185, which is more than or less than our alpha that we set in the second step. More than or less than? More than. More than you reject or fail to reject null hypothesis. Fail to reject. Therefore, you are going to conclude there is no significant relationship between knowledge and age at the point level of significance 0.05, where the RS value is equal to 0.263, positive and low correlation, P 0.185. Itu maksudnya. Dan orang baca, orang tahu. Tak ada perkaitan pun antara umur dan juga knowledge. Semakin tinggi umur seseorang, adakah knowledge DLP-nya bertambah? In this particular data, that is not the evidence. Faham eh? Maknanya ini bukan bukti yang menunjukkan lagi berumurnya awak, lagi bijaklah awak dalam DLP. Tidak. Jelas? Jelas eh? Okay, same also goes to the knowledge and also salary. Knowledge and salary, ini dia punya RS. Nilai dia adalah minus 0.0, eh? Not 0.1. 0.019. Less than 0.2, based on Gilford rule of thumb, it's indicate negligible negative relationship. Betul tak? Nor dia. Nature of relationship menceritakan direction and strength. So, based on this, less than 0.2, maka dia dikira sebagai negligible negative relationship. And you can also justify that basis based on your p-value. P-value kamu berapa? 0.924 is more than alpha or less than alpha? More than. Reject or fail to reject? Pandai. Fail to reject your null hypothesis and therefore you are going to make a conclusion there is no significant correlation also between knowledge score and salary. Betul tak? Tidak ada perkaitan. Tidak ada perkaitan yang signifikan antara knowledge dengan salary. Jelas? Nampak ke tak nampak? Ke suam-suam nampak? Nampak kan? Jelas. Okay. Itulah dia punya kisahnya dalam kita punya penceritaan correlation. Now, we already know and understand about differences hypothesis test. We also know already how to make a correlation test. Now is the time for you to understand about one more test. We call it as the K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K-K- Chi-square ada dua fungsi. Namakan fungsi-fungsinya. Saya persilakan Puan Mariam. Mana Puan Mariam? Saja je main sebut nama ni. Mana Mariam? Ha, silakan. Apakah fungsi... apakah tadi fungsi apa? Apa soalan saya? Saya pernah tanya. Apakah fungsi chi-square? Ha, silakan. Tak jadi, tak apa. Jawab je. Salah, tak apa. Paling-paling pun kena marah je. Ha, tak tahu je. Contoh. Alright, silakan Puan. Apakah yang you understand?